A car several feet underwater. Young victims trapped inside.
Ages 1, 5, another age 5, ages 6 and 7.
Team coverage tonight on this emotional story, from the crash to the difficult rescue.
Incredibly cold, nearly freezing temperature water.
To the ongoing effort to save those little lives. At this hour, all 5 children who were in that car remain hospitalized at Hennepin County Medical Center and Amplatz Children's Hospital. We're all pulling for them. We know you are, too.
Yeah, it's got to be such a tragedy for the family. And it was a difficult morning for the first responders and the emergency crews as they pulled those young children from the car after at least 20 minutes underwater. It's difficult for anyone to witness the scene off Highway 7 and 100 in St. Louis Park around 6 o'clock this morning. This view from Chopper 5 shows you where it happened. Now, the water in this pond right here is about 8 to 9 feet deep. Tonight, our Beth McDonough is live at the hospital checking on the conditions of the children and their mother. And our Tim Cherno is live in St. Louis Park to walk us through the crash and the rescue. And Tim, let's start with you.
Well, Leah, the lighting conditions now would have been about what they were this morning. I don't know if you can see the holding pond behind me. How many of us drive by holding ponds just like that one all the time and never stop to think how cold that water is or how deep it is? Well, there isn't a guardrail here to prevent simply going off the road from turning into a tragedy.
I heard a woman screaming very loudly, "Help me, help me, help me."
From his balcony, Jeffrey Robertson can see the holding pond, and this morning in the dim light,
I could see the outline of somebody in the pond, you know, and you could see they're about knee deep in the water.
He says he called 911.
I yelled across to her that, you know, the police are coming, help is on the way. You know, and at that point she stopped screaming, she calmed down, and, you know, 2 minutes later, you know, the police showed up.
They just said over the scanner that there were the children in the car, as many as 4.
5 Eyewitness News photojournalist Jeff Ganahl.
I came up 100.
Was on Highway 100, minutes away.
I see a whole different situation now.
So his camera captured the rescue efforts. According to the State Patrol, the car was going westbound on Highway 7, heading northbound on Highway 100 when it jumped the curb and plunged into the icy water.
Yeah, she was about 25, 30 feet out from the corner here.
Robertson saw the driver.
She came out and she, you know, she was hunched over and you know, they had a blanket around her.
And he watched the children pulled out, carried to shore.
They were up like this. You know,
in my 40 plus years of photojournalism, I had never seen anything like this. Never.
As the moments turn to minutes,
I'm out here waiting to see, you know, are they getting these little ones out? And, you know, first it was 3, and then, you know, there's 4, and then, you know, now they're saying 5, and it's like, oh my gosh. You know, you don't want to hear that, and that car had been underwater for so long, you know, it makes your heart sink.
It's good words. It makes your heart sink. Well, we check with MnDOT. This entire area of Highway 100 is due for a big change. Folks going westbound on Highway 7 to go northbound on Highway 100 won't go past this holding pond anymore. When the project is complete, they'll go across 7, make a left-hand turn, and circle around under the bridge. This will be different. This won't be here. Live in St. Louis Park, Tim Cherno, 5 Eyewitness News.
The driver of that car is 23-year-old Marion Garrido, Brooklyn Center, and 3 of the injured children are her own. The 2 others are her boyfriend's kids. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Beth McDonough is learning more about this family, and she is live at the Hennepin County Medical Center tonight, where some of the kids are being treated. Beth.
Yeah, Leah, it is really a heartbreaking night tonight at 2 hospitals for 2 families, the Garridos and the Rennies. As you mentioned, 3 children we have confirmed are here at HCMC. They are still listed in critical condition. They are hanging in there. 2 other children have been transferred over to Amplatz Children's Hospital. All 5 of them, after being submerged underwater for so long, well, it's really touch and go for them. Marion Garrido was driving the car full of children. These 3 are hers, 1-year-old daughter Aliana and 2 sons, Alarius, who's 7, and Imani, who's 5. She had her boyfriend, J.R. Rennie's, 2 other children with her, 6-year-old Zarahena Rennie and 5-year-old Zenavia Rennie. The couple had the youngest daughter, Aliana, together. It's not clear if the kids were wearing seatbelts or restrained by car seats when the car plunged into the dangerously cold pond water. The kids were unconscious when rushed to the hospital this morning. At last check, Rennie's 2 daughters were listed in serious condition.
We talked with longtime neighbors and friends of Garita's in Brooklyn Center, who had no idea what she would be doing in St. Louis Park so early in the morning.
She even helped him raise her boyfriend kids. She's a good mother.
Kids were very nice little children.
That driver, again, 23-year-old Marion Garrido, she wasn't injured, and she also shouldn't have been in the driver's seat at all. And that's because State Patrol confirmed with us late this afternoon that she did not have a valid Minnesota driver's license. Now, we did also reach out to a J.R. Rennie's family, to his relatives, also to him in particular. We left a message on his cell phone. We haven't heard back yet. But authorities tell us that really it's a very tough night. Some tough decisions are being made at two hospitals tonight. Live in Minneapolis, Beth McDonough of 5 Eyewitness News.
The four older children go to school together at Odyssey Academy in Brooklyn Center. And when students get to school tomorrow, a counselor will be there to work with them. The school also plans to send a letter home to parents, which will include suggestions for helping their students get through this tough time.
They're an awesome family. They're fantastic, and I want to keep it positive. I just want them to know that we're praying for them and hope for the very best.